Xin mời chơi ông quý chú.
The President, please be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir, mesdames et messieurs.
Le président. The president, the court is now in session.
Nous reprenons l'audience.
The session here is
cette
about the testimony of Mr. Nayan Chanda regarding the armed conflict. Before we start the proceedings, the greffiers are invited to verify the attendance of the parties to the proceeding today. The greffier, Mr. President, the parties to the proceedings during today's hearing are all present. The expert is also present here in the courtroom.
Le témoin expert est également présent.
The President,
le président,
during yesterday's session,
au cours de l'audience d'hier,
we moved up to the stage in which the co-prosecutor was putting questions to the expert. There are still questions
il lui reste
to be put to the witness, the expert. So we would like to give the floor again to the co-prosecutor to continue putting more questions. The floor is yours.
Permettre de poursuivre. Le co-procureur international.
Thank you, Mr. President, and good morning, Mr. Chanda. Perhaps can I remind you, first of all, that you are still on oath.
Rappeler que votre témoignage est toujours sous serment.
You mentioned yesterday that when you went to the border provinces in March 1978 in Vietnam, you learned that in the first 5 months after the Khmer Rouge came to power, so after the 17th of April 1975, more than 150,000 Vietnamese flooded into the border regions of Vietnam from Cambodia. Can I ask you to, if you can recall, let us know where you heard that from? What were your sources for that particular information?
Pouvez-vous me donner la source de cette information?
From what I recall, that information
d'après mes
came
souvenirs,
from
cette information
of the authorities,
des
foreign ministry
des
office in Ho Chi Minh City,
du bureau des affaires étrangères situé
à
Ho Chi Minh,
dealing with the press, and who actually escorted me to some of the camps when I visited in March 1978.
Et m'ont escorté dans cette zone frontalière en mars 78.
I wonder if you will, could you please describe these camps
question,
in general terms?
Voudrais vous inviter à
how big they were,
me donner une description
what
de
you saw,
ces campements,
where, whether you had any interviews, you conducted
voir,
interviews of people
si
at these
oui
camps.
Ou non, vous avez, interviewer des gens qui s'y trouvaient.
The camps
réponse,
I visited of different
les camps
size
où je me suis rendu
some
étaient
of the larger
différentes
camps were located in
certains des camps
former
les plus importants étaient
military
situés
base,
dans l'ancienne base
just a large
militaire.
Area with
il s'agissait d'une vaste
very minimal,
zone
security or enclosure.
Avec un périmètre
people had set up huts,
minimum, des gens avaient construit
and
des cabanes
and it's
de bambou,
very, very basic
de chaume.
Housing.
Il s'agissait de logements précaires.
And it seemed that the some of the refugees, young men in particular, were acting as a sort of policing or looking after the discipline or sort of order in that camp. And I did interview quite a few camp inmates, most of them without any official being present. So I thought they were more likely to tell the truth.
L'arrivée des blindés vietnamiens
and the route of the Khmer Rouge allowed them to actually flee where they were located in the eastern border region. And so they said that they were
la défaite des Khmer Rouge leur ont permis de s'échapper et ils étaient
from their own homeland,
tout à fait contents d'avoir pu s'échapper et d'être arrivés
hope that
là où ils étaient, ils ont exprimé leur espoir de retourner au Cambodge lorsque le régime des Khmer Rouges prendrait fin. Et j'aurais demandé, mais qui pourrait libérer le Cambodge? Et la réponse que l'un m'a donnée était, bien sûr, ce sont les Vietnamiens qui vont libérer le Cambodge. Ils voulaient retourner chez eux.
Can you perhaps just be very clear on the ethnicity of these people in the camps? Were they of one ethnicity or were they of many or several?
De ces personnes dans ces camps? Y avait-il des personnes d'une seule souche ethnique?
I cannot be absolutely sure.
Not réponse,
having spoken to more than a few, but they look like mostly Khmer. Because the
réponse, puisque j'en ai interviewé que quelques-uns, mais je ne travaillais que par l'intermédiaire d'un interprète Khmer, mais c'était principalement des Khmer.
You said the camps were of differing sizes.
Question, vous
perhaps
avez dit
it might be difficult looking back now. But are we talking in the dozens of refugees, if we can use that word, in the hundreds or in the thousands?
Peut-on parler de centaines de réfugiés ou de milliers de réfugiés?
In the thousands.
Réponse, il s'agissait de milliers de réfugiés.
Moving on to something you told Her Honor Judge Cartwright yesterday.
Passons maintenant à un sujet que vous avez abordé avec Madame la Juge
Cartwright You were discussing the policy of the Khmer Rouge to prisoners or people they came upon during the armed conflict. And you said something that I'd like you please to perhaps elaborate on. You mentioned that generally, if my note is correct, the policy was not to take prisoners. Could you explain from where you learned this? What were your sources, and whether you learned the reason for the Khmer Rouge not taking prisoners as a matter of course?
Que, en espèce, les Khmer Rouge ne faisaient pas de prisonniers.
I cannot
réponse.
Give a specific
je ne peux pas
source for that observation
pas
because that is something
de vous donner
that
une source d'information spécifique.
You learn over the course of
quelque chose que vous apprenez. Au fur et à mesure
which were attacked by the Khmer Rouge,
que vous vous rendez dans des endroits
and the aftermath of those attacks,
attaqués par les Khmer Rouge et après,
because whenever the Khmer Rouge would capture a prisoner, most of the time, I think they would broadcast on Radio Phnom Penh that we have in our hands the proof of the aggression by the Vietnamese
nous
because we have captured some of the enemy.
Radio Phnom Penh, la
preuve but that
de
kind of reports were, to my memory, few and far between.
je dirais que mon souvenir.
And yet we know that there were many Khmer Rouge attacks
along the border. Il n'y avait que très peu de prisonniers pris. Et nous savions qu'il y avait des attaques Khmer Rouge le long de la frontière. Mais étant donné le fait qu'il n'y avait pas beaucoup de prisonniers,
being taken as reported,
en tout cas signalé comme
and the general brutality
tel, et étant donné la brutalité d'ensemble dont j'ai pu être témoin, eh bien, c'était ma conclusion.
You alluded there to question. Radio broadcasts.
Vous avez fait référence à des communiqués radiophoniques en réponse à la question de la juge.
And again, I'll be corrected if my note isn't accurate, that generally prisoners were not taken unless they were otherwise useful. Could you just elaborate on what you meant by prisoners being otherwise useful?
Alors, qu'est-ce que vous vouliez dire par « à moins d'être utile par ailleurs »
My hunch would be that people who were taken prisoners were thought to be, at least by the Khmer Rouge, of some rank who would have more information to yield than a simple soldier or simple militia person.
So, ou de membre de la milice de base.
And if I, again, it's my memory si may be faulty, but my recollection is that whenever read the transcript of Radio Phnom Penh broadcast of Vietnamese prisoners being presented, and their ranks were given.
De prisonniers
now, whether that rank
ayant été
designation was accurate, I
fait
cannot
par les
say.
Rouges,
but
eh bien,
it seemed to me
leur,
that
on
very
leur
rarely
rang
be
militaire.
Presented with the name of a Vietnamese
donc,
prisoner who was just a simple soldier.
Selon mes souvenirs, on ne le présentait pas dans ses communiqués radiophoniques.
Did you notice anything particular
soldats.
About the content
question.
Of the broadcast of these Vietnamese ranking confessionals? Was there a
contenu,
pattern? Was there any particular purpose that you could determine?
Particulier, un objet particulier à ces communiqués radiophoniques que vous avez pu écouter. Là encore, je dois admettre que j'ai une mémoire qui n'est peut-être pas exacte, puisqu'il s'agit d'événements il y a plus de 30 ans, mais je dirais que
and they confessed that Vietnam has
this
aggressive design on Cambodia. So it was to
simply
strengthen their case that Vietnam has this aggressive design on Cambodia rather than any other information.
Donc, plutôt que de donner d'autres informations spécifiques qui étaient transmises à l'ensemble du public, il s'agissait en particulier de communiquer ce type d'informations par ces avis.
My last topic is
question.
The lull
that
we have talked about in the fighting, certainly the lull in the reporting of fighting.
Nous avons parlé de l'accalmie dans les combats.
And my question is, after the very first armed attacks by Vietnam and by Cambodia on the islands in 1975, and up until the main assault of the Vietnamese
de
in strength in Cambodia in 1978, late 78.
À la fin de l'année 78.
Was there anything that might be called
a
general conclusion of peace between those two dates, concluded between
dates,
Cambodia or Vietnam, to your knowledge?
Une période que l'on pourrait considérer comme étant paisible,
I have
en train
no
de paix entre le Cambodge et le Vietnam.
Peace agreement or deal
je n'ai pas de souvenir de,
other than
d'accord
some local
conclu
arrangements I have heard from
sauf exception de certains
Vietnamese sources
certaines dispositions prises
who were a bit ashamed by the
dont j'ai pris connaissance
deal that was struck between the provincial authorities in Vietnamese side
entre
and the Khmer Rouge
les accords
to take back some of the people who fled from Cambodia to Vietnam in the early years, early months after the Khmer Rouge victory.
Au cours des, and often, premiers mois suivant la victoire the, Khmer
those who were sent back were Khmers or Cham
or
non-Vietnamese ethnic
group.
And they were returned in exchange for draft animals. Some sort of exchange was done. During that kind of return of
des échanges au niveau escapees local ont lieu from Cambodia. Pendant,
so that was what I recall having been the kind of local
donc, c'est ce que j'ai pu apprendre de,
peace agreement or return
ce qui est de,
d'accords
locaux
escapees.
S'agissant des personnes qui s'étaient échappées.
And apart from such local agreements, were you able to recall, are you able to recall any official policy of détente between the two countries, any official peace talks that concluded in peace?
No, there were several attempts,
several
visits by Vietnamese leaders to Phnom Penh in
75.
And also in 76, but those attempts did not lead to any lasting or even for a short period a truce. They were, in my recollection, very inconclusive.
Selon mes souvenirs, ces négociations n'ont pas abouti.
Mr. President, in due course, the co-prosecutors will seek to put certain documents before the trial chamber, but in the interests of a speedy hearing of this particular witness, we don't seek to do so at this point, but we inform the court that in due course, at the proper time, we will seek to put certain documents relating to the international conflict before the chamber. Thank you.
Ces éléments ultérieurement. Donc je vous remercie.
President, Judge Lavergne, the floor is yours.
Monsieur le juge Lavergne, je souhaite intervenir, je vous en prie.
Oui, je voudrais revenir, monsieur l'expert, sur un point que vous venez d'aborder. Vous avez indiqué, sauf erreur de ma part, qu'il y aurait eu des accords locaux afin de... Alors, je ne sais pas très bien comment qualifier ça, de permettre le retour ou de remettre aux autorités cambodgiennes des personnes qui se seraient réfugiées sur le territoire vietnamien, des OFF notamment État, de la situation de minorité, notamment
de minorité Cham.
Est-ce que j'ai bien compris ce que vous avez dit? Est-ce que vous pouvez nous dire si vous avez des éléments particuliers ou des sources particulières qui vous permettent d'étayer ces affirmations?
Honorable Judge, I do not recall any detail, but I know that I mentioned this fact of forced repatriation of some Cambodian national by the Vietnamese in my book. And if you permit me, I can perhaps find the reference and see whether what kind of source I used for that information.
Consulter mon ouvrage à ce moment-là, je pourrais vous confirmer les sources que j'ai pu utiliser pour sur lesquelles baser ces informations.
Monsieur l'expert, éventuellement, ce qu'on peut faire, c'est qu'au cours de l'audience, vous nous donniez ces références. Ce n'est pas nécessaire, c'est trop cher à cet instant. Je pense que les instants de la Chambre sont très précieux. On va peut-être passer à d'autres questions.
Our time is very precious, so you might be able to provide us with this during the course of the hearing.
The President, the Co-Prosecutor, the floor is yours.
I don't know whether this assists, Your Honour, but in the English version of Mr. Chanda's book, at page 85 in the English, and the ERN number is, if you excuse me, 00192270, there is, roughly two-thirds of the way down the page, a reference to repatriation of Khmers who had fled from Cambodia to Vietnam in recent months. And that is footnoted, footnote 19, which appears at the back of the English book at page
423. 423,
which has an English ERN of
dont la cote ERN est
00192608.
Il s'agit de la note de bas de page 19.
And I'm sorry to rise to my feet to again, but there is a further reference in the book which specifically relates to a transaction involving livestock, and that is at page 85 in the English, ERN 00192270.
Zéro.
The President,
le président.
The co-prosecutor, I notice your Monsieur presence. Which matter you require to raise?
Que vous souhaitez intervenir?
I do apologize, Mr. President. I do apologize for making the observation. It was in relation to Judge Laverne and his request to the witness for sources for the deals of repatriation that took place, and I was pointing out that at page 85 of the English version, footnotes 19 and 20, there is reference to the source material.
cambodgien et les sources dont, que l'auteur avait utilisées pour ces informations.
The President, Judge Lavergne, do you have anything else to add?
Monsieur le juge Lavergne, avez-vous à quoi que ce soit à ajouter?
The President, next.
Le président.
The Chamber would give the floor.
La chambre souhaite
to the civil party lawyers.
Co-avocat des groupes de parties civiles.
To put questions to this expert.
À poser leurs questions.
And because of the changes in our program and our scheduling, this time we rotate and now we start with Group 4 first. Hong Kong Soon, the floor is yours.
Rotation, à savoir que nous allons commencer par le groupe numéro 4. Maître Hong Kim Soon, vous avez la parole.
Mr. Hong Kim Soon, thank you very much, Mr. President. I am on behalf of Group 4. Your Honours, in our group there is Mr. Olivier Sure, who also takes part in the process, but however I would like to put questions on his behalf to Mr. Nayan Chanda. The first question is about your compilation of the document in Khmer. It says brother, enemy. Could you please elaborate the terms brother enemy in your book,
because
here in the hearing we focus on the armed conflict between Vietnam and Cambodia, and it has some connections to the CPK regime in which a lot of people were perished. So I would like you to kindly elaborate the term brother enemy.
Et donc j'aimerais que vous aidiez ce terme, les frères ennemis. La réponse.
Thank you very much for your question. I chose the title to basically designate the relationship between the Cambodian and the Vietnamese parties, but also relationship between the Chinese and Vietnamese parties.
Cambodge, both Vietnam, et également
these sets of relationship avec were les autres, very intimate at one stage, and the party literature propaganda always talked about fraternal solidarity between these parties, and yet both the Vietnamese and Chinese fought a bitter war in 1979, and the Vietnamese and Khmer fought long battles along the border, and then eventually a big war in 1978-79. So the fact that they were brothers once and then became enemies, this fact applied to both these sets of relationship, and that is why I chose the title brother enemy.
Ce titre, c'est la raison pour laquelle j'ai choisi ce titre marquant cet antagonisme, les frères ennemis.
Mr. Hong Kim Soon, thank you very much. The next question also links to the title of your book.
La question suivante est liée au titre. De votre
if I am not mistaken, you
si je m'égare,
regarded the alliance between the Communist Party of Vietnam and the Communist Party of Cambodia, that kind of relationship or intimacy that you indicated that they are more like fraternal relationship. Was that only that the people because of the
uniquement parce que
the merge or the relationship between the two parties that you call this a kind of brotherhood or whether because of other previous relationship between the two countries that you call them brothers.
Relations qu'entretenaient ces pays par le passé que vous appelez, vous avez défini ces pays comme étant des frères.
Chose the title specifically with the communist parties of Vietnam, Cambodia, and China in mind, not necessarily the people of these countries.
En termes de parti communiste,
that is not to say that there were not fraternal and good relationship between the people of these countries. They were, and most of the time, they had a very
very friendly and peaceful existence. La coexistence entre ces différents peuples aura été pacifique, mais assurément, au cours de l'histoire, il y a eu des moments où les relations ont été tendues, conflictuelles. Ce n'est pas cela que j'avais à l'esprit. Cependant, dans le choix du titre de mon ouvrage.
Mr. Hong Kim-soon, thank you.
Merci,
the next question is concerning the time in which the conflict erupted between the Communist Party of Vietnam and the Communist Party of Cambodia. In your book,
dans votre livre,
on page number 5 in Khmer,
à la page 5 du texte Khmer,
and with the ERN number 001 913 10 in document D91/1. In the second paragraph,
au deuxième paragraphe,
of your document, it is about the second Indochina war, which has not ended. The third war started. It was the war between brothers and brothers and comrades and comrades.
I think
I would like to point out to another new term, which is about comrades. You mentioned about brothers and brothers, but now it is more about comrades. Was it the term you referred to the Communist Party of Vietnam and that of the Communist Party of Cambodia or Cambodia?
Yes, I use the word comrade.
Oui, le terme camarade
identify them as communists.
Leur donner leur identité de communiste.
Mr. Hong Kim-soon, thank you.
Monsieur, Maître Hong Kim-soon, merci.
I may now move to the same topic of Vietnamese Communist Party and
alors
Democratic Cambodia
pour ce qui est
Communist Party. There were two major conflicts.
Il y avait deux
you, through your experience, you lived in Saigon,
ici,
known as Ho Chi Minh City,
vous étiez basé, je crois,
before
à Saigon,
South Vietnam was liberated.
Avant la libération du
according
Vietnam
to your research,
Vietnam,
in 1972 and 1973, I think you already stated about this matter, but I would like to pinpoint
parlé,
this so that there is a linkage to the matter.
Point,
now, when it comes to the conflicts between the Vietnamese troops in Cambodia territory, and you mentioned that at that time the United Nations had close relations with the Communist Party of Vietnam to negotiate with
with
the Khmer Rouge troops so that there was a peace
en vue
installed, but the Khmer Rouge did not agree with the peace deal. At that time,
le compromis de paix.
After the collapse of the Lonnol regime,
après la chute du régime de Lonnol,
and there was a conflict between the Cambodia and Vietnam, I'm wondering whether this is the consequence left over from the previous war.
Qui resterait de la guerre précédente.
Yes, indeed. As I indicated yesterday,
comme je l'ai indiqué hier,
as a result of the first Indochina war,
suite à la première guerre d'Indochine,
Indochinese Communist Party later on broken up
into three parties,
fought
par la
the
suite
French,
s'est scindé en trois, aura lutté contre la France.
War was concluded in the Geneva Agreement of 1954.
Avec les accords de Genève de
54, the loser was the Cambodian Communist Party because they did not get any representation at the conference and they did not get any recognition whatsoever
as
having been a fighter for anti-colonial struggle.
Comme ayant Vietnamese été un des contributeurs de cette lutte anticoloniale.
Some 2,000 Cambodian cadres
cambodgiens
go to Hanoi
ont
to
été autorisés stay there. À aller à Hanoi pour y rester.
And so that
par les Vietnamiens
was seen by
et
the
cette
Cambodian
situation était perçue par
many Cambodian communists, not
de
all,
nombreux communistes cambodgiens, mais
betrayal.
Pas tous, comme étant
and
une
that
trahison
word has been used in many I think Khmer Rouge documents.
Cela and est reflété dans de nombreux documents.
So when in 1973 the Paris
lorsque
Peace Accord between Vietnam and the United States was concluded,
at that point,
the U.S. government negotiators pressured Vietnam very much to bring
très
their Khmer Rouge allies to the table. And I recall reading
et je me souviens
in,
d'avoir lu
in Henry Kissinger's memoirs,
dans les mémoires de Henry Kissinger,
that Kissinger admitted that he
l'aveu de Kissinger
hadn't realized how independent of the Vietnamese the Khmer Rouge were,
son ignorance à l'époque du degré d'indépendance
que le Khmer
Rouge à l'égard des Vietnamiens.
Force them to come to the table.
Lorsque
it is,
les
they
Vietnamiens
are beyond our
Kissinger,
control.
Nous ne pouvons pas les forcer à venir à la table
Kissinger
de négociation. C'est au-delà de notre capacité. Kissinger n'avait pas trop l'air
but
de vouloir croire
his memoir,
les Vietnamiens.
By that time,
mais
he had
les années ayant passé, lorsqu'il a écrit ses mémoires, il avait
et
enfin compris avec le recul de l'histoire que les Khmer avaient leur propre volonté
and the Khmer Rouge movement.
Donc, et
so,
qu'il était absolument impossible
question,
d'avoir
yes,
le moindre entente entre le mouvement Khmer Rouge et l'Onnol. Il y a assurément, pour répondre à votre question, un leg, quelque chose qui reste sous cette forme-là du premier conflit.
Mr. Hong Kim-soon, thank you.
Merci, Dimitri Hong Kim-soon.
The follow-up question is that when the Khmer Rouge did not agree with the peace deal negotiated by the negotiators of the U.S., at that time, the troops of the Communist Party of Vietnam who stationed in Cambodia,
who
expelled. It means that the Khmer Rouge had a fighting with
autrement
the Vietnamese
dit,
troop, but did the Khmer Rouge expel the Vietnamese troop out of
est-ce
Cambodia at that time?
Qui ont expulsé les soldats vietnamiens à l'époque?
I do not
le
know
témoin.
That I can use the word expel,
je ne sache pas
that
que l'on puisse utiliser le terme
using
expulsé.
Of force.
Parce que ça voudrait dire l'utilisation de la force.
Would guess that the Vietnamese
mais je présume que les Vietnamiens étaient
indésirables.
Ils avaient déjà
a massive blow to the Lonnol government during the 71
infligé
period.
Un revers considérable
so
au régime Lonnol dans la période précédente.
But
et donc, il était plausible qu'ils puissent se retirer de leur
Vietnam
fait.
Or pro-Vietnamese
mais
elements
des gens avec des sympathies pro-vietnamiennes
then inside Cambodia and
se trouvaient
they were arrested and executed.
À and in that connection, I might,
Judge Laverne yesterday asked me about
the evidence hier
of any such killing during the 72-73 period.
And I had
found one reference in David Chandler's book, Voices from Esteps 21.
And
with your permission, Mr. President, I would like to read one passage from this book which is relevant to this question. David Chandler writes that the accused may well have developed his elaborate notion of treachery involving strings of traitors within courts between 1972 and 73. When a secret operation was set up by the Khmer Rouge to purge the so-called Hanoi Khmers, Cambodians who had come south in 1970 after years of self-imposed exile in North Vietnam, ostensibly to help the revolution. Hundreds of them were secretly arrested and put to death in 1973 after the Vietnamese had withdrawn the bulk of their troops from Cambodia. A few managed to escape to Vietnam after detention, and others were arrested after April 1975. Many were arrested in the special zone. The stealth and mercilessness of the campaign may have owed something to Doig's emerging administrative style. The campaign indeed foreshadowed the modus operandi of S21. This is page 21 to 22 of the book Voices from S21.
Traduction française, c'est la page 39, ajoute l'interprète.
Mr. Kum Suan, thank you. May I ask you the next question about the aftermath of the conflict? I know that you noted already that the Khmer Rouge forcibly driven away the Vietnamese troops. At that time, maybe I'm not quite sure, maybe before 1970, and I don't remember the page reference. When it comes to the agreement, whether that agreement was a treaty, an agreement, or just a promise, and do you still recall that between the Republic of Vietnam, I refer to the Communist Vietnam and the Communist Party of Cambodia or the National Front led by then Prince Norodom Sihanouk. Was there any treaty or agreement or official promise signed concerning the war to liberate
en vue d'une
the
guerre,
country from both Lonol and also the war to liberate from the liberate the South Vietnam? Do you think there et was such a treaty, for example, if the Vietnam won or was victorious,
si
then parts of the maritime border and islands, for example, were to be given back to
the
Cambodia. Have you been familiar with this?
Avez-vous quelque information que ce soit là-dessus?
I am not aware of any treaty.
Qu'il y ait du
I suppose treaty should be would have to be signed between two sovereign entities,
and the
Cambodian liberation movement was not a sovereign entity, but there were joint communiqués issued by the two parties
qui
promising to cooperate to liberate their respective countries. And I do not recall seeing any reference to the disputed islands or territories being returned. It is entirely possible that in some unpublished annex of such a communique there was such thing, but I am not aware of it.
Non publié de ce type d'annexe, il était question de cela, mais je n'en ai pas
conscience.
Merci.
Mr. Hong Kong-soon, thank you.
Hong Kong-soon, merci.
After the Khmer Rouge, fought the Lon Nol soldiers and regime and won in 1975 and compared to the time when the South Vietnam was liberated on the 30th of April. And according to your document, the capture of Koh Tral or Koh Krocha Seh in the same book you mentioned about the forcibly deportation of the Vietnamese of roughly 500 civilians
environ 500 civils vietnamiens
with the ERN reference number 001 in Khmer 9 1 3 1 8 8
en Khmer.
It is about the
ici
the Khmer Rouge troops which captured that islands on the 4th of May 1975. So are you familiar or you recall about any agreement about the deal regarding the Koh Tral or Phu Koch in Vietnamese? Are you aware of that deal?
Ou Phu Koch en vietnamien.
I am not aware of any
non,
deal specifically.
What I recall is that entente,
I think in
spécifique.
June 1975 there was a visit by Vietnamese Party Secretary General Le Xuan, and I think during that visit,
it was
I think announced that
Vietnamese
were going to return, pull away to Cambodia, which they had captured earlier in their retaliatory action. Apart from that, I do not recall whether there was any other statement involving
Koh
Tral
or
the Ses Island.
Ou sur Kratchak Ses.
Mr. Kim Hong, thank you.
Maître
in your book, it also states
votre livre, par ailleurs,
that after 2 weeks, the Vietnamese soldiers retaliated the Khmer Rouge soldiers and captured the Khmer Rouge soldiers. Were you aware that when Vietnamese troops recaptured the island and the Khmer Rouge soldiers were captured, were there any exchange of the wars or the prisoners of wars?
No, I do not believe I heard any such development involving exchange of prisoners. But I wouldn't be surprised if there were.
Ceci dit, je ne serais pas surpris que cela ait pu se produire.
Mr. Hong Kong-soon, thank you very much.
Merci.
My next question is related to the question raised by the co-prosecutor. I would like to verify it, but I cannot recall the exact time. Vietnam made a proposal to exchange the Khmer people who fled to Vietnam together with some combatants or cadres in exchange for livestock. At that time, Did the Khmer Rouge object to the exchange or not? And after that, were there any further exchanges or the transfer or repatriation of the Khmer Rouge or the Khmer people to the East Zone within the Democratic of Cambodia territory?
Vers la zone est du Cambodge démocratique.
This information I obtained in 1981 from
a
Cambodian official in Svayriang, and he told me that in early 1977, the Vietnamese provincial authorities allowed the Khmer Rouge to select 49 refugees from a camp in Mok Hoa in Vietnam.
Au sein d'un camp à Mok Hoa sur le territoire vietnamien,
they were exchanged for one bull per person.
Selon les termes, une tête de bétail par personne.
Look, Mr. Hong Kim Soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kim Soon.
Yesterday, you spoke about the armed conflict that the Khmer Rouge invaded into a village in a border, near the border of Cambodia and Vietnam, that was the Thai Ninh province.
Dans la province de Thai Ninh,
and the Khmer Rouge soldiers killed the Vietnamese civilians.
Tué les civils, des civils vietnamiens.
You also talked about the incursion of the Vietnamese troops into the Vietnamese territory that was raised by you yesterday.
C'est vous qui avez évoqué cela
hier. Was the large-scale attack or incursion by the Khmer Rouge troops into the Vietnamese territory before the Vietnamese started their large-scale invasion into the territory of the Democratic of Cambodia?
Par les Vietnamiens sur le territoire du Cambodge démocratique, est-ce que avant cette période-là, il y avait eu des incursions d'ampleur?
Initiative in attacking border
le
villages.
Témoin, oui, l'initiative d'attaquer des villages frontaliers revenait au Khmer Rouge.
On April 30th, 1977, there was a major attack, and then also in September 24th, 1977, there was a major attack. So the Vietnamese, a major offensive followed the Khmer Rouge attacks that did not precede them.
A suivi de la part des Vietnamiens, a donc suivi, mais n'a pas précédé les attaques des Khmer Rouge.
Look, Hong Kim Soon, Mr. Hong Kim Soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kim Soon, merci.
Yesterday, you also talked about the large-scale attack, and then the Vietnamese troops withdrew themselves. Also, in your book, you talked that Son Sen, Kai Pok, and Tam Mok led their troops to the border between Cambodia and Vietnam at the eastern zone.
Dans la zone est.
Also in your document,
vous dites
you write about the joyful activities by the people of the Khmer Rouge victory. But I think this is just a means by the Vietnamese not to create war so that they withdrew themselves and then the Khmer Rouge would incur into the Vietnamese territory. My question to you is that the cause of the conflict in these minor forms started from 72 to 73,
and
before the incursion or the armed conflict in large scale.
Les incursions et le conflit armé.
The conflicts already started from the time of the liberation of the country by the Khmer Rouge, or when the North Vietnam liberated the South Vietnam. Were there any connections from the smaller conflicts to the major large-scale wars or only the conflicts because of the disagreement between the two communist parties?
Est-ce qu'il ne s'agit que de conflits dus au désaccord entre les deux partis communistes?
I need to clarify one point.
That
while there was arrest and execution of pro-Vietnamese, or supposedly pro-Vietnamese Cambodian communists in 72-73 period, there was
dans la période 72-73,
a tactical alliance again between the Vietnamese Communist Party and the Cambodian Communist Party
et le PC
in
1974,
when it was clear that the United States is going to be withdrawing
déjà que
and
les États-Unis Khmer Rouge allaient se retirer de la région,
could actually take
et
power
que les
in Cambodia.
Pourraient effectivement prendre le
Vietnamese
pouvoir en Cambodge.
Were
et
willing
là,
to help the Khmer Rouge.
Étaient prêts à ce moment-là à aider les Khmer Rouge.
April 17th, 1975, victory of the Khmer Rouge was made possible by significant Vietnamese arms supply and training provided to the Khmer Rouge in 74, particularly late 74 period.
And that was the time
when Chinese
were
unable
to
provide assistance and because they had no independent means and their supply had to be delivered through the Vietnamese who had a
les common border with China. Devaient être fournis par
and so as a result,
Vietnam,
Vietnamese Communist Party provided very valuable assistance to the Khmer Rouge for their final victory on April 17th. So that was in some ways an aberration in otherwise conflictual relationship.
Dans ce
so
qui est par ailleurs une relation fondamentalement conflictuelle. J'ai donc le sentiment, l'intuition que
that by
les Vietnamiens espéraient qu'en fournissant une assistance aux Khmer Rouge, ils pourraient les gagner à leur propre façon de voir les choses.
Wrong.
Et leur calcul était erroné, comme on s'en est rendu
victory,
compte. Dès que les Khmer Rouge
they,
fact, ont remporté leur propre victoire, ils ont annoncé qu'ils ont remporté cette victoire tout seul,
and that was
sans la
a moindre
aide étrangère.
That was broadcast by Dien Ong Phen,
cette annonce faite par
completely Khmer victory without
Phen
any assistance. So Vietnamese understood that they were not going to get any gratitude from the Khmer Rouge
et n'appartenait à personne d'autre. Et donc le Vietnam a immédiatement compris qu'aucune gratitude de la part des Khmer Rouges ne serait
Mr. Hong Kong Soon, thank you.
Merci, dit Maître Hong
Kong Soon. I asked you about the conflict between the Khmer Rouge and Vietnam in 72 and 73, and subsequently the Vietnamese removed from Cambodia. So what were the reasons why the Vietnamese assisted the Khmer Rouge in a later stage?
Yes, as I indicated, Vietnamese are aware perhaps under the wrong impression that
peut-être
they had more friends in the Cambodian party than they really had. So they were hopeful
plus
that by supporting the Khmer Rouge, giving them very vital
donc,
assistance,
en apportant
they would
un soutien vital au Khmer Rouge,
gain
ils avaient l'espoir de pouvoir
gratitude and perhaps support of their friends
la gratitude et
in the party. And in that connection, I
de leurs
like to note,
amis au sein
I
du Parti cambodgien. Je voudrais signaler que j'ai récemment
scholar,
lu une recherche écrite par un russe concernant les relations Vietnam-Cambodge sur la base de matériaux d'archives diplomatiques russes, soviétiques, qui ont récemment été rendus publics. Et ce chercheur russe dit que Nunchia était
that
la
Pol Pot always sent to
Pol Pot
ask Vietnam for
Pol Pot
help
envoyait systématiquement
and be the Vietnamese person in the party.
Vietnam.
and it was Nunchia who was dispatched to seek Vietnam's help before the fall of Phnom Penh in 75. And this similar pattern was repeated later on. And
Vietnamese
certainly thought, I know for sure that Vietnamese thought until 1978 that Nunchia was perhaps a moderate person and a friend of Vietnam.
Les Vietnamiens pensaient que Nunchia était un modéré et un ami du Vietnam.
Mr. Hong Kim-soon, thank you. My next question relates to the negotiation or the agreement
concernant la négociation
on the conflicts at the border,
concernant
which
les conflits frontaliers,
ultimately led to the attacks or the incursions by the Khmer Rouge troops into Vietnam and also by the incursion by Vietnam back into the Cambodian territory. In your document,
dans votre texte,
it states about the large-scale attacks by the Vietnamese in the first attacks in Vietnam by the Vietnamese into the DK territory. First is to show that the Khmer Rouge, to show the Khmer Rouge that the Vietnam was strong and would not tolerate. And second, to expel the Khmer Rouge troops from their territory. However, it also reads that the Vietnamese troops chased the Khmer Rouge troops into and reached into the Kampong Cham province without any resistance in 1977. What I want to ask is, what was your observation and what was that led to the Khmer Rouge to have revenge on these large-scale attacks by the Vietnamese troops? Were any property destroyed or Khmer civilians killed by these Vietnamese attacks?
Est-ce que les attaques vietnamiennes ont tué des civils?
I'm afraid I have no clear memory as to the details of those operations, but it seems to me that the attacks were more a show of force by sending in tanks rather than actually destroying many places. So I have no specific knowledge about that, but that is my general sense that there was not much destruction as such.
Simply a show of force. Il s'agissait surtout de montrer qu'on avait les moyens d'être fort.
Mr. Hong Kim-soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kim-soon, je vous remercie.
My next question.
Ma question suivante. Ma question
relates to the time when the Vietnam handed back the Pulawai Islands to the Democratic Cambodia, but the wars kept continuing.
Et que le conflit a continué.
In your document,
dans votre texte,
you said that
vous dites
Nunchia congratulated the handover of the island, but the war kept continuing, and that led to the large scale attack or incursion the second time by Vietnam into the Cambodian territory toward Phnom Penh, and ultimately the fall of the Khmer Rouge regime.
La prise de Phnom Penh et la chute du
in your research,
dans vos recherches,
did that event relate to the dispute or disagreement for both the land borders and maritime borders?
A-t-il été lié au conflit frontalier et au conflit lié à ces îles?
I believe that
réponse,
by the
j'ai le sentiment
end of 1977,
fin de 77,
the Vietnamese had concluded that it was not the question of misunderstanding
ne s'agissait pas d'une question
question
de malentendu
resolving some ou de territorial de dispute or boundary dispute. It was a more fundamental question
territoriaux. Il s'agissait d'une question fondamentale Vietnam, ayant trait à la politique des Khmer Rouges envers le Vietnam.
Has to be resolved by
et
the change of policy in Phnom Penh,
une solution or if that is not possible, sous la forme d'un changement de politique à Phnom Penh,
in other words,
ou en changeant les personnes ayant le pouvoir à Phnom Penh.
Party,
en d'autres termes, s'il y avait des changements à l'intérieur du parti
public,
du Cambodge démocratique, eh bien,
mais si tel
n'était pas la chose, s'il n'était pas possible de changer les personnes au pouvoir à Phnom Penh, eh bien,
so I think it was no longer a question of territorial dispute,
la paix
but it
et
was
la stabilité,
a more fundamental
eh bien,
political
de,
dispute.
Prendre Phnom Penh.
Mr. Hong Kim Soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kim Soon, je vous remercie.
I have two or three more questions for you.
Me reste deux ou trois questions à vous poser.
In the armed conflict that is between 75
armé entre
to 79,
et 79,
that is within the decay period,
au cours de la période du régime,
were the armed conflicts between the Democratic Cambodia and Vietnam,
le Cambodge démocratique et le Vietnam,
and were there any armed conflicts between the DK regime and Thailand? Did you do any research on this particular point?
Avez-vous effectué vos recherches sur ce point spécifique? Réponse.
As I mentioned yesterday, that there were clashes with the Thai troops and the Khmer Rouge troops. But that was clearly on the question of border demarcation, where the border actually lies, because there were cases where the border markers
où se trouvait la frontière,
placed by the French in the beginning of 20th century, were removed in different places, and so that unmarked or ill-defined border was the cause of some clashes. But this was insignificant politically, because this was purely a territorial dispute and not a political dispute.
De conflits territoriaux simplement et non pas de conflits politiques.
Mr. Hong Kim Soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kim Soon, je vous remercie.
This is a follow-up question.
Il s'agit d'une question.
In your document, I cannot locate it. It is more about the dispute. May I ask the President's Liu whether the expert observed during the conflict between Vietnam and Cambodia that Khmer refugees, correction from the interpreter, the dispute between Thailand and Cambodia, whether the repatriation of Cambodian refugees, 26 of them who were sent through Aranya Prathet in Paipat town into Cambodia. Was there a negotiation between Cambodia, ruled by the Democratic Cambodia regime, and the Thailand to repatriate these people? Was there any agreement? May I ask you to clarify this?
Y a-t-il eu une entente à ce sujet-là? Puis-je vous demander de détailler ce point?
I have no recollection of such agreement. You know,
je n'ai pas souvenir d'un tel
entente.
Comme j'ai dit,
remember.
Ces événements datent d'il y a longtemps et je n'en ai pas de souvenir.
Mr. Kim Soon, thank you. The last question, may I ask
la suivante.
You to clarify a little bit concerning the history of Vietnam and Cambodia, as stated in your book, and all you said yesterday that
Vous avez dit hier,
I may not be sure about this, and I may want you to clarify that not only the Communist Party of Vietnam, but also the people of Vietnam have the notion of taking more lands from Cambodia. Was that the part that led to the more conflicts between Vietnam and Cambodia?
Est-ce que cela joué dans la montée de ce conflit entre le Vietnam et le Cambodge?
In the Black Book,
dans le livre noir,
the Khmer Rouge made that assertion.
Les Khmer Rouges.
The nature of the Vietnamese, that's the word they use, the nature of the Vietnamese, meaning all Vietnamese, whether they are from the imperial time or whether they are from the time of Ho Chi Minh, they all have an expansionist and annexationist approach towards Cambodia. That was the Khmer Rouge conclusion, that the Vietnamese as a people were expansionist.
Pour ce qui est de l'intégralité du peuple, a été un peuple expansionniste.
Mr. Hong Kong-soon, thank you very much, Mr. Nayan Chanda, and thank you, the President and your honors. May our colleague continue putting some more questions.
Je vais laisser la parole à mes confrères.
The President. The floor is now given to lawyers of Group 3 who would wish to put questions to the
expert.
The floor is yours.
Vous avez la parole.
Monsieur le Président, le groupe numéro 3 ne posera pas de questions.
Mr. President, Group 3 will not have any questions to put. Thank you.
The President, next, Civil Party Lawyers Group 2, the floor is yours if you would wish to question the expert, Mr. Nayan Chanda. Mr. Kong Pisai, thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of Civil Party Lawyers Group 2, I have no more questions at the moment because
the
expert was significantly asked. The President, I would like to invite Civil Party Lawyers Group 1 to put questions before the expert.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Good morning.
Bonjour,
Mr. Chanda. My name is
Chanda.
Alan Werner. I'm a co-lawyer for Civil Party Group 1, and I'm representing Civil Parties with my colleague, Tishrina. As I said yesterday, we have only one question for you.
And here is a question. You said yesterday that the U.S. military operation in Cambodia, you mentioned, I believe, two times this military operation. So could you confirm for us the fact that the American bombings in Cambodia stopped in August 1973? Is that correct?
That is what I recall. But then there was bombing in 75 when Mayaguez was captured by the Khmer.
Un bombardement en 75.
But concerning the one in 1973, for that year, it stopped in August.
Du bombardement 73.
Yeah, I think so.
Les bombardements se sont arrêtés en
Thank
août.
You. We
c'est
have
bien ça?
No further questions.
Je vous remercie, répond Maître Werner. Nous n'avons pas d'autres questions à poser.
The President. We would like now to give the floor to the Defense Council to put questions to Mr. Nayan Chanda if they would wish to do so. The floor is yours. Thank you very much, Mr. President. I may not have a lot of questions because regarding the conflicts armed conflicts between the CPK and the Social Republic of Cambodia was the matter, the top matters between the two states. It was nothing to do with S21. And I would only wish the expert to confirm just in one word whether Vietnam was aware that when the people were exchanged, for example, in the east, in Swai Rieng, that one person was to be exchanged for a cow. In Swai Rieng, a person was exchanged with a bucket of salt. So Vietnamese took a basket of salt and then returned a person. Sometimes 20 or 30 people were exchanged. My question is that are you familiar that the Vietnam actually was quite familiar that the people who were exchanged were later on executed in Cambodia.
Et est-ce que le Vietnam savait que ultérieurement ces personnes qui avaient été échangées étaient ensuite éliminées?
I did not know the story about the basket of salt.
Alors, je n'ai pas je n'ai pas connaissance de ce que vous avez décrit
avec
ces échanges contre
that the Vietnamese undertook this repatriation.
Mais
I think in the full knowledge of what might be
les Vietnamiens ont entrepris de telles remises,
maybe awaiting those repatriate person. But that is also my supposition. I have no knowledge, direct knowledge.
En pleine conscience.
And as I said, I learned about those exchanges from a Cambodian official in 1981.
En 81, c'est que ce que m'a rapporté un responsable. Un responsable cambodgien, reprend l'interprète.
Mr. Casabot, could you please confirm, my question is that whether Vietnam was familiar that the people who were exchanged were killed here in Cambodia. Of course, Vietnam, the Vietnamese got the basket of salt, the cows to be cooked, I mean, but here in Cambodia, people who were exchanged were perished. Did you know that?
Au Cambodge, ces personnes échangées,
as I indicated, that I had no direct knowledge about those exchanges. I heard it from this Cambodian official, so I cannot speculate as to how much the Vietnamese knew or what happened to those people who were exchanged.
Ce qu'il advenait de ces personnes.
Xin mời chương trình được vị François Roux.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Mr.
Bonjour,
President.
Monsieur
Hello,
l'expert.
Mr. Nayan Chanda. Thank you for
témoignage.
Your statement.
Monsieur le Président,
Mr. President,
à ce stade, je souhaiterais
this
que
level
l'accusé
in
puisse,
the proceedings, I would like the
avant
accused,
que je pose mes questions, faire lui-même quelques commentaires.
A few comments before I ask him my questions.
En présence de l'expert,
so I would like
réagir à ce qui a été dit jusqu'à présent.
To react to what has been said in the presence of the expert. Interpreter corrects. I'd like the accused to react.
The President, Mr. Kang Kek Il, the floor
Monsieur
is yours.
Je vous donne la parole.
So,
Mr. Kang Kek Il, thank you, Mr. President, for allowing me to make some comments concerning the achievement of the expert, Mr. Nayan Chanda.
Sur le travail de Monsieur Chanda.
Through my observations, the good things of the achievement of Mr. Nayan Chanda is that the achievement is very significant.
Et que les travaux de Monsieur Nayan Chanda sont considérables.
A lot of events were captured according to what Mr. Nayan Chanda has recollected.
Rapportés par et nous ont été communiqués par le biais du récit de Monsieur Nayan Chanda.
He saw the events. He read them, the materials, and you were aware of the events.
Les documents et il avait connaissance des événements.
In conclusion, the reason I said it is significant because there were a lot of good collections of historical events compiled in the book.
Le livre présente une compilation d'événements historiques.
The second good achievement is that you show us the major notion
et que vous ne savez
that concept according to my understanding and I would be corrected
et corrigez-moi si je me trompe.
It was the notion from which the expert heard from Pam Van Dong directly, verbally.
Qui a été échangé avec le témoin, que le témoin a évoqué avec Pam Van Dong.
So, mình dạy là Pam Van Dong.
Pam Van Dong was the Prime Minister of the Socialist Republic
de la République Socialiste du Vietnam.
Tam ca sang khai.
According to your summary concerning the concept mentioned by Pam Van Dong,
it
included 3 points.
Il y avait 3 points.
First, which is the first step, that the Communist Party of Cambodia, Le Yun, would like to educate Pol Pot to follow their way.
Éduquer Pol Pot pour lui permettre de suivre le même chemin que lui.
If they could not succeed in doing so, then they allowed the Khmer in the Democratic Cambodia to topple Pol Pot.
Autoriser les Khmer du Cambodge à renverser Pol Pot.
Number three, if all fail, then there would be from the outside attack.
Une attaque venant de l'extérieur du territoire cambodgien.
These are the main concepts I heard from the expert yesterday, if I am not mistaken.
Que nous avons
these concepts
entendu de la bouche
according to my understanding
et d'après ce que je comprends.
I would like to now elaborate and make an analysis.
J'aimerais
regarding the concepts,
les choses et présenter une analyse,
which is in paragraph 3 of my comment.
Concept, cela est contenu dans le paragraphe 3 de mon commentaire.
It was part of the implementation of Ho Chi Minh's theory.
De la théorie de Ho Chi Minh.
Ho Chi Minh stated that the only main cause was the struggle against the French.
Était la lutte contre les Français.
Therefore, there must be only one ruling party, which was then called the Indochina Communist Party.
Le Parti communiste d'Indochine.
One party, one soldier, one government.
Un gouvernement.
One country, which was then the Federation of Indochina.
Fédération indochinoise.
This was the theory of Ho Chi Minh, as I stated yesterday in the hearing.
Hier, au cours de l'audience.
It was the source of life and death,
source de la vie et de la mort.
Hostility between Lay Yon and Pol Pot.
Et Pol Pot.
Lay Yon was the secretary of the Labour Party of Vietnam, which was later on changed to the Communist Party of Vietnam.
Monsieur le Président, il y a un problème avec la traduction.
President, there's a problem with the translation.
J'aimerais que l'on répète le nom du secrétaire du Parti communiste vietnamien.
Secretary of the Communist Party to be
en
repeated,
français.
Please, in French.
Ça n'est pas ce que nous a
this
été
is
dit.
Not what was communicated to us.
Alors,
so, or...
est-ce que vous pouvez épeler,
could you please spell it out, Mr. Duke, the name of the Secretary
épeler?
Of the Communist Party of Vietnam?
The accused.
L'accusé.
Française, Monsieur le Président, on parle de Monsieur
Mr.
Le Duan.
So we're speaking about Mr. Le Duan for the purposes of the French translation.
Monsieur Le Duan.
Mr. Le Duan.
Pas Leon. Not
Monsieur Leon.
Le Duan.
Mr. Le Duan. Not Mr. Le Duan.
Merci.
Thank you.
Le Duan. Som Okun.
L'accusé.
Bikmai.
The accused. I think it is good there to clarify the term.
Je pense qu'il est essayant de clarifier, de préciser
the term
ce terme.
June. Actually, I did not intend to
en fait, non,
look down on the Vietnamese by using this term.
D'utiliser un terme péjoratif pour qualifier les Vietnamiens de Yon.
Comme somme tante,
I would like to continue.
J'aimerais poursuivre.
The conflict between Lay Yun and
Le
Pol Pot.
Conflit entre Lay Duan et Pol Pot.
Was a life and death conflict.
Eh bien, il s'agissait d'un conflit mortel.
It was a protected conflict.
Il s'agissait d'un conflit protégé.
Ramrai.
Un conflit.
It was a protracted and long conflict.
C'était un conflit s'étendant sur une longue période de temps.
Starting from 1954, he still boasted himself as the father of the Indochina, even if there were a Geneva Convention.
Le père de l'Indochine, en dépit de la conférence de Genève.
Even if there were a Geneva conference,
même s'il y a
interpreter
eu
corrects.
Une, l'interprète se corrige, même s'il y a eu une conférence de Genève.
That's what I informed the chamber yesterday.
C'est ce que j'ai dit hier devant la chambre.
That's the conflict between Lay Yun and Pol Pot. They tried to topple one another.
Ils ont essayé de se renverser l'un l'autre.
And the expert also raised a number of issues and clarified those issues.
Un de points et a étayé ces points.
Although the armed conflicts existed,
bien que le conflit armé
they were
existait,
within the framework that Lay Yun wanted Pol Pot to follow him.
Souhaitait que Pol Pot le suivent. Et ça, c'était le cadre.
I would like to express my thanks on the three main concepts by Pan Wandong as raised by the expert.
Quant à ces trois concepts de Pan Wandong qui ont été relayés, communiqués par l'expert.
So these three, the conflicts which led to the open armed conflicts raised and was aware by the international community in 1978.
En 78, qui a dont on a été informé la communauté internationale.
On the 31st of December 78, they announced in public that there was an open war. I would like to state that Pol Pot and Lê Duẩn had personal conflict.
Avaient des conflits, étaient en conflit personnel.
Each had their own party.
Chacun avait son propre parti.
Had their own soldiers.
Disposait de ses propres soldats.
Therefore,
par conséquent,
the disaster caused the bloodshed and the lives of the normal civilians.
Bain de sang et tout cela a eu pour résultat un désastre pour la vie des civils, de la population civile.
Dear Honours, what I have said is not to say that he Pol Pot was the greatest patriot of the country.
N'avait pas pour but de dire que Pol Pot était le grand patriote du pays.
Pol Pot was a murderer. He was a murderer.
Pol Pot était un assassin. C'était un assassin.
He was the father of the murderer of Cambodia.
Père de l'assassinat du Cambodge.
The lines set out by Pol Pot in the revolutionary flag in 1973.
Dans le drapeau révolutionnaire en 73,
which he state whatever class lines of that class origins that was for that class origin.
De classe. Il s'agissait de d'origine des classes.
It means the Communist Party of Cambodia was the proletarian class.
Représentait la classe prolétaire.
If you are a member of the Communist Party of Cambodia, you had to build yourself following that class.
Doit se construire comme appartenant à cette classe.
If you cannot build yourself, then you would be removed from the party or you would be smashed.
Classe, on doit être éliminé du parti et on doit être éliminé. Point.
I also informed the co-investigating judges on the 21st of October 2008. In the document D90/2/1 at page with ERN 00 023 023 079 079. In that document, I informed the court that in whatever forms that Pol Pot tries to hit himself,
Car il est difficile de déterminer si c'est 19 ou 90. Alors, il est question dans ce document de Pol Pot.
The document's reference was D90/2.
D90/2.
So it was D90/2/1.
D90/2/1.
In that document, I did not think of Pol Pot as the patriot. He had blood on his hands.
Donnait pas l'idée de Pol Pot comme étant un patriote. Il avait les mains couvertes de sang.
Pol Pot used the slogan, if we want to defeat the Vietnamese, we had to be clean in our ranks and we had to be clean amongst ourselves.
Dans nos rangs et propre en notre sein.
So I still maintain my stance that it was the conflict between Pol Pot and the Indo-Chinese Federation in the first point.
Qui était une, à la source.
In that conflict, Pol Pot was the murderer.
Et dans ce conflit-là, Pol Pot était assassin.
And more than 1 million people were killed under the hand of Pol Pot.
Ont perdu la vie aux mains de Pol Pot.
And in that, S21,
et dans ce cadre-là,
my hand stained with blood of those S21, who were killed at S21. There were
12,340
people.
Du sang des personnes qui
380
ont
people,
perdu la
correct
vie
by the interpreter.
À S21, 12,380 personnes.
I did not denied from the spirit of being responsible for this crime. I just want to show the conflict between Pol Pot and Le Duan was long and protracted.
Était une affaire de longue date.
The Vietnamese and Khmer bloodshed flew because of the conflict between these two people.
Le sang vietnamien et cambodgien a coulé à cause du conflit entre ces deux personnes.
And I would like to conclude with my observation on the words used by the expert.
Concernant les paroles utilisées par l'expert.
The title of your book is that
le titre de votre livre
is Brother Enemy.
Est frère ennemi dans la version anglaise, frères ennemis dans la version française.
If you talked about Korea, then I would support it.
Si vous parliez de Corée, par exemple, je serais tout à fait d'accord.
They had a joint history.
Il y a une histoire commune. De la Corée.
They had a joint territory.
Il y a un territoire commun de la Corée.
And they had a joint language.
Et il y a une langue commune de la Corée.
As for us and Vietnam,
pour ce qui nous concerne,
we never had
le
any joint
Vietnam,
territory.
Ça n'a jamais été un seul territoire unique.
I wished Korea and China to have
Chine.
Good fortune and
je
to reunite like the case of the Germany.
La bonne fortune de vivre en bonne harmonie et je souhaite aux deux Corées d'être réunies comme ça a été le cas pour l'Allemagne.
Finally, I would like to express
enfin,
my appreciation to your achievement
ma gratitude
and your work.
à l'expert pour l'œuvre accomplie.
That you write the expressions of Pam Van Dong in your book.
Relevez les propos de Pam Van Dong dans votre livre en particulier.
If I use the language of Pol Pot, that would have no value. But you carry it out and you show the words by Pham Van Dong and it has great value.
En lumière les propos de Pham Van Dong et cela est extrêmement précieux.
Once again, I would like to thank you, Mr. Expert, for listening to my statement.
D'avoir entendu mon propos.
And I apologize if my opinion is different from yours.
Si je présente une opinion qui diffère de la vôtre.
Thank you, Mr. President. That is the conclusion
Merci,
of my speech.
The President.
It is now time for adjournment.
Le président. Il est
and
temps
also it's time for the IT section
pause.
To change the tape.
Il est temps
the chamber will now take 20-minute break
cassette
until
Donc,
10 past 11 when the court will be back in session.
Nous reprendrons l'audience à 11h10.
Court officer, assist the expert.
L'huissier, veuillez raccompagner
and to provide him with a refreshment
dans la salle de repos.